And the main reason why I have invited you here today, gentlemen, is that by using the Bible as a map, I can now prove to you the reality of quantum teleportation by providing a very simple demonstration.
A demonstration? You're kidding me, right?
Mathematics. The key is mathematics. Everything in the universe is structured around the number 7. Refract a beam of white light. What do you get?
A rainbow.
A rainbow. Roy G. Biv. 7 colors. In music, do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. And with do, or 8, you begin the next octave. The height of a human adult, 7 times his own head. The same pattern can be plainly observed in the 7 days of creation, or as I like to call them, the 7 frequencies of quantum reality relative to consciousness.
You want to run that by me again?
Gentlemen, it's like this. Where a preacher says, God's spirit hovered over the face of the deep, I say, consciousness, unlike light, cannot be drawn into a black hole, and thus the two repel like the same poles of opposing magnets. Why? Because gravity has no power over consciousness. Because consciousness has no weight.
Yeah, but there's no hard evidence to support the fact that consciousness has no weight.
So tell me, Gary, I'm sorry, Dr. Lewis, how much does your mind weigh?
Brain weight varies slightly from individual to individual. Since I've never weighed mine, I wouldn't know. But based on what you're selling, I would venture to say that mine is a lot heavier than yours.
You can laugh all you like, gentlemen, but there is a difference between the mind and the brain. Memory, and thus consciousness, has no weight. It operates from a dimension outside of space-time. This is why you will never find the smallest particle, and why information and its storage will continue to get smaller and smaller as we continue as a species through the 80s, the 90s, and into the future. This is why quantum realities exist to begin with. Space and time are constantly changing, expanding and contracting, but consciousness stays the same.
Consciousness stays the same, so why do we forget?
Because we, as conscious beings, sometimes attach ourselves, our identities, to physical things. Things we experience in space and time. And as these things change, we experience loss and pain. And then?
Do the same thing all over again.
Yes. Unless we realize that we are consciousness, what the Bible calls soul, and that space and time are expanding and contracting in reaction to the frequencies emitted by our soul, or consciousness, and not the other way around. Gentlemen, do you understand what I am saying? Death is just an illusion. We've been here the whole time, and now I can prove it.
Yeah, tell that to my grandmother. So wait. So how do you do it?
Quantum teleportation? Simple. With this.
A pill.
Quantum teleportation isn't about space or time. It's about consciousness. So in order to participate in this process, you must alter your consciousness. What did you think? We were going to jump into a DeLorean and go 88 miles per hour?
Okay.
I'm celebrating!
What?
I'm celebrating!
Celebrating what?
I just heard the most amazing lecture on metaphysics you could possibly imagine. This guy named Kwame Mutom or something like that. I'm not positive, but I think I can use some of his ideas for my own research to change the whole game.
You're funny. What's your name?
Jerry.
I'm Linda. My friend thinks you're cute.
What?
I said my friend thinks you're cute. Well, she's not really my friend. I just met her. So don't tell her I said that.
Hey. Name's Jerry.
What?
Step exhausting. I'm not alone. I'm not alone. No, no. I feel you draw me closer. All these burdens on my shoulders.
Myself, I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul of faith. I was around when Jesus Christ had his moment of doubt and pain. Made damn sure the pilot washed his hands and sealed his fate. You is the nature of my game.
late morning slate. And what are we interested in today? Political science? Abstract mathematics? Ancient history? Language arts?